Hi, I'm James Erskine, the writer and director of The White Room. It's a contemporary psychological thriller about London today. It's meant to be an investigation of the world that we live in and the people that we maybe see as invisible or don't know, and how their own psychoses are driven by the city. It's an art house movie, but it's a movie with a message. Well, what I was interested in is the way that when people come to cities, how they can get lost. I've lived in lots of different cities, and the idea of language and communication and the way that people get trapped. You move to a city, like the great story of Dick Whittington, you know, he comes to London, he makes his fortune. Well, obviously lots of people come to London, they're here to make their fortune, but everyone sees the sort of the possibilities, but the difficulties of living in cities that don't offer support to people when they come here, you know, was really the foundation point. And then the idea of people that are invisible, we call migrants invisible members of the economy, but they're visible, real people. And I wanted to show the humanity and the stretches on the mind, really, that happened. Alberto is an economic migrant to London. He's come here because he wants to make money to support his family back home. His father's died, his mother's ill, you know, he needs to make money to come back here. He's an intelligent guy. He comes here with you know, a good idea to make money, make his fortune, make money in the city and go back home. He wants to go back home. It's not this right-wing agenda of people that want to live here. He wants to, you know, share his skills and then go back home. But what he finds is that it's a difficult city, and, you know, he becomes unnerved by the city, and things start to play in his mind from his past, and you realize that he's a man with a darker past, and actually maybe the reason he's come here is because he's running from the past as much as trying to seek a future. And we chose to put Oscar Janeda, who's a fantastic Spanish actor, we wanted to bring him here, and really he gives an amazing central performance as the you've got to love him because he's the center of the film, but you know, he plays everything out, you know, the stress of living in a city, the stress of what it's like. And I think this is a common feeling. I don't think you need to come from Colombia into London. I think if you come from Manchester, as I did, or other parts of the country, you come to a hard city, and you know, if you live in a dangerous city, you start to dream of dangerous things. You know, we're all growing up, we grow up as children, and we're you know, in certain cultures, we have certain beliefs that come about, Catholicism, this is about Christianity, beliefs that come about, and they play on our mind in moments of weaknesses. And what he's trying to do is he's trying to make sense of chaos. If a city like London is chaos, he's trying to make sense of chaos, and he reverts back to what happens in his own childhood, and he imprints this, and it drives him mad because in itself it's chaotic. He's looking for meaning where no meaning exists, and I think this is sort of his journey to try, and he tries to find himself by delving in the past, but actually what he wants is a future. And we live in a world where everything is about the future. It's forecasting, it's predictions of opinion polls. Who's going to win the election? You know, what's the weather going to be like tomorrow? In a world where you're obsessed about the future, you know, it's hard to keep a sense of the present. I really wanted to cast a movie which is full of people that aren't from London, actually. I think this is a story of the city, and, you know, there's Oscar, who's a Spanish actor playing a Colombian, Kai Alexander, who's a fantastic young actress, you know, she's obviously Chinese origin, Bill Paxton, Scottish, you know, who wants to be mayor of London in the film. Yeah, Melia Kraling is in the film. She's a Greek actress. You know, we wanted to cast it with people that weren't necessarily the traditional voices that you see in British cinema or on British television, but they actually represented the true voice of the city, the chirruping languages of a Babel. And I think, you know, we set out to find actors that we thought have got a really bright future. And, we actually shot the film a couple of years ago, and I think, you know, these people are going to be seen very widely in the future. And we have Velibor Topic, who's a Bosnian. You know, we've really gone for like a range of different faces and different looks because we wanted to make a film that was different, I guess. We weren't trying to make, a conventional film in any sense with this film. We wanted to make a film that was a pure piece of cinema that was driven by the visuals. And I think one of the great things about it is the photography by Joel Devlin. It's a very it's like being within a dream. You know, it's about a man who has dreams. It's like being within a dream. And that's what we wanted to convey. It's a challenging piece of cinema, but we hope that, you know, people enjoy and love it. So, well, the good thing is Wembley to Soweto we connected with because of David Westhead, who was an actor and also an executive producer, and was executive producer on the movie and helped me develop the script. A wonderful guy, and he'd been working with children and young people, disadvantaged communities and immigrant communities, to give them tools to tell stories, which is obviously we're storytellers, they're storytellers. And so what we did, which is uniquely, is we invited those photographers to be our behind-the-scenes photographers. And there's photographs, they're here tonight taking photographs, but they also, they did all the behind-scenes coverage. And these are people that have come from very stricken circumstances. So it was great that they were able to partner up, and they're here tonight. And it's an amazing charity. And what's great is about its empowerment. It's about giving skills, and giving skills gives identity. And if this film is about somebody who loses their sense of themselves, what Wembley to Soweto does, it gives young people who don't have a strong sense of themselves a sense of their identity.
My name is Velibor Topic, and I've been in this country for the last 23 years. I'm originally from Bosnia and Herzegovina, and I do play Bosnian in this film. It's been really nice to finally be here after about, I think, 4 years. As I remember, I was doing a film in France at the same time, and at the same time I was coming back to London to finish this, to do this film, which is a wonderful script, really a touching script about a destiny, a life of one person, and I play his best friend, and this time I play a rather nice guy, I think. Usually I play bad guys. But it's been an absolute pleasure to work with James and Oscar and with, you know, all these guys in the film. And it's been a long time ago, but as if I remember really well, it is a great script. So a really pleasure to be in this film. I was saying to my friend Andrew, producer, he said, who is James? And I said, James is the guy who is gonna go to the end. Until he's really happy with the take and with the frame. So that's how I remember James. And he's very, very precise and very detailed. And this is what I liked about James, because details make a character, you know, look good. Not only look good, but the story being really interesting. So James, for me, is somebody who really appreciates and enjoys working in the film and working with actors. And that's why I liked working with him. It's absolutely, you know, first what I see in someone is just a great, great personality, great person, and this is what Oscar is, and that's what makes him a great actor, because everything comes from being humble, being modest, and being fantastic on set with everybody, and that's how exactly I am, not just with directors, producers, but with everybody else, and that's how Oscar is, and I really, really enjoyed working with him, and I hope he's going to show, you're going to see that on the film, as much as it was seen on our days of filming, you know. Yeah, I did recently a film with the young director Tom Edmonds, who he was a personal assistant to Anthony Minghella. He's a fantastic director who I did Breaking and Entering with. He was his assistant, and now he's an actor. He's a director and a writer. We did this film called Dead in the Week with Tom Wilkinson and Chris Eccleston. I've done that. Now I'm at the moment doing Mission Impossible 6. So with Tom Cruise, so it's not bad. Well, first of all, Tom is always surrounded by so many people around him, you know, who protect him and look after him. Start with 6 bodyguards and the rest, let's just don't go even, you know. But he's a very calm person, I'll say. And when he's not, that means something went wrong. And he's absolutely amazing. I've seen him doing stunts. And it's just, you have to be brave. You have to have something in you to do that, and what he does. And well done to him. You know, it's absolutely a pleasure working with him, to be honest with you. And it's such a huge project with the rest of the actors, not just Tom, but, you know, the rest of the actors.
Where have you been filming for that? Because obviously the franchise always takes us to exciting locations. Is that here? Or
I've done 6 weeks in Paris. Then they're going to New Zealand. I was going to go, but I'm not going. And then we are back in London again in July and August.
Can you tell us anything about your character in that? I'm assuming, I mean, you're playing a nice guy in this one, but I'm assuming maybe not so nice in that one.
I don't think so, but I can't tell you anything about that, because you know how they are on that film. Yeah, that would kill me.
Hi, my name is Oscar Jainada. I'm the main character of The Quiet Room, and I'm so happy to you to be here. Well, when I read the script for the very first time, I've seen an immigrant story. No, it's like how the people has to manage to travel themselves to be happy and to find his place in the world. And when I read it the first time, I saw a human trouble, not an immigrant trouble or just an Colombian guy in London. Is there a human problem? What do you have to do when you are in another place? It's not your house, your people is not here. How you manage that situation when you have something weird or something strange. And it happens to Alberto in this movie. He has something weird, something strange. He has nobody to share what he's feeling, and the paranoia starts. And this is a movie about paranoia and human paranoia. I used to travel a lot. I used to travel alone, and I know what is that. No, I know what that means to be alone in another country when even the language is another language. You can understand anything. So it was easy in this part of the work of my interpretation, because I know how you feel when you got this, when you saw something weird and you don't know how to explain it, and you don't have anybody at your side to talk about that, and that weird thing begins to raise, and it becomes your life, and the paranoia becomes your life, and that's a problem, and it happens to Alberto. He's in a strange city with another people, and it happens to him. Well, James is a great director, and I have full confidence with him. So it was like he came to Spain to convince me to be in this movie. So that's the thing I love of the directors, no? The passion, and he wants to me to be in this movie, and I'm in. So he made a great job. We're shooting for a long time, more than 14 hours per day. Was very heavy, but it's maybe the cold, because I'm not used to being in a country with such a cold. But and it was rainy days. It were a lot of work, but it was so easy for me and for James. That it is the really important thing is James, and for James was a very good film. So.
Fans have been enjoying seeing you on screen at the moment in a very different project in Snatched. Can you tell us a little bit what your experiences were like working on that one with obviously Goldie and Amy, two wonderful talents to be involved with?
Well, it's amazing. We just released 2 weeks ago in US, and it was great. So happy to be in this movie. It's a comedy, but it's not a normal comedy. It's with Amy Schumer, and Amy Schumer is one of the most heavy comedians I've never worked with. She's so talented, and it was so crazy to work with someone who is always improvising, who she was always giving to use new words and all that stuff, and you have to climate to her actuation. So it was crazy, but it's Amy Schumer. She's so talented with that character, you know?